Welcome to the Windows Club. If you encounter the error "fail to obtain IP address from DHCP server," then either read through this article on the website or simply watch this video. I will guide you through the resolutions. The first solution is to check the status of DHCP. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command ncpa.cpl and hit enter. Doing so will open the network connections window. Double click on the active network connection. In the general tab, click on details. Make sure that DHCP enabled is checked at yes. The next solution will be to restart the DHCP client. There are certain commands for this. All you need to do is copy these two commands. It will stop the DHCP client and restart it. Then search for command prompt in the Windows search bar and click on Run as administrator to open the elevated command prompt window. In the elevated command prompt window, copy and paste both of these commands and then type Y and hit yes to restart this. After this, the next solution will be to restart the DHCP client service from the service manager window. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command services.msc and hit enter to open the service manager window. Scroll down to the DHCP client, right click on it and select restart. The next solution will be to run the network adapter troubleshooter. Right click on the start button and select settings. In the settings window, go to the system tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select troubleshoot. Click on other troubleshooters. Corresponding to the network adapter troubleshooter, click on run. The next solution will be to release TCP IP flush DNS. This has been explained over a separate article and video. Lastly, you can consider reinstalling your network adapter drivers. The best way to do so is to go to intel.com. Search for the network adapter drivers in the Intel search bar at the top right corner. Download these drivers and install them on your computer. This would be the latest version. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.